Look at this example 6.2. It is well known that a raindrop falls under the influence of downward gravitational force and the opposing resistive force. The latter is known to be proportional to the speed of the drop, but is otherwise undetermined. Consider a drop of mass 1 gram falling from a height of 1 kilometer. It hits the ground with the speed of 50 meters per second. What is the work done by the gravitational force during this displacement? And what is the work done by the unknown resistive force? So these two things we have to find out. So mass of raindrop is 1 gram, height with which it is falling is 1 kilometer. We have to find out work done by gravity, W due to gravity is equal to how much, and work done by resistive force. When the drop is falling down, air resistance opposes the motion of the drop. So, as the speed increases, air resistance also increases. There is a state when the force due to gravity becomes equal to the force of air resistance. Both being equal and opposite, the net force on the drop becomes zero. And then thereafter, the drop moves with a uniform velocity. This uniform velocity, or this type of uniform velocity, is called terminal velocity. The velocity with which the drop moves with constant velocity in the air is called its terminal velocity. That velocity is given to be 50 meters per second. The velocity with which the drop hits the ground is 50 meters per second, and 1 gram is its mass. So, how much is the kinetic energy of the drop? Kinetic energy of the drop is given by half mv square. Half 1/1000 into 50 square. So this is half 2500. How much this is? 2.5, half 1.25 joules of energy. This is the energy with which the drop hits the ground, right? But the total work done by the gravity is how much? Total work done by gravity is, work done by gravity is mgh. This is the weight, is the force which is acting on this drop. And this drop has displaced by a distance of 1 kilometer. So total work done by the gravity on the drop is again 1/1000 into 9.8 into height. That is again 1000. So this is 9.8 joules. So 9.8 joules of work is done by the gravity on the drop. So total work done by gravity plus work done by resistive force should be equal to the gain in kinetic energy should be equal to gain in kinetic energy. So kinetic energy of the drop is 1.25 joules. Kinetic energy of the drop is 1.25 joules. And work done by gravity is 9.8 joules. 9.8 joules plus WR. So how much work is done by the resistive force? Work done by resistive force, WR, will be equal to 1.25 minus 9.8. So how much is this? To simplify this, minus 8.55 joules of work is done by the resistive force. So is this example clear?